इधर। తాజాగా అందిన సమాచారం ఏంటంటే ఒక అతను ఆరు హలీములు కొన్నాడు భయ్య, ఆరు ఫ్యామిలీ బ్యాగ్స్, ఫ్యామిలీ బ్యాగ్స్ కొన్నాడు భయ్య, ఆరు ఫ్యామిలీ బ్యాగ్స్ డిస్ట్రిబ్యూట్ చేయడానికి భయ్య. కొట్టేందరు భయ్య జనాలు, బ్లాక్ బ్లాక్ లో టికెట్లు కోసం కొడుకున్నట్టు. రైస్ ఆర్ దాల్చా బాయా మసాలా
history behind the haleem specifically, because you know it's not, is it a
Hyderabadi
dish?
I cook Hyderabadi food,
right?
And you know Hyderabadi food is a mostly evolution of Muslim cooking,
right?
And you see there is a there is some food which is common to both the Hindus and Muslims,
right?
And in fact most of the food is common. But yet, you know, the influence, Muslim influence on the food is very, very distinct.
Okay.
Because, you know, the very concept of cooking rice and meat, it is Central Asian concept, brought from that. And this similarly, you know, this haleem, it has been, it is being cooked throughout the Muslim countries. From Turkey to Arab countries, except I don't know about Indonesia or Malaysia, I have no knowledge about that. But otherwise, all the Muslim countries, they cook haleem. Say some call them haris in Arab.
Haris, yes.
Yes, in Turkish they call it something different. But they are all wheat and meat based. And naturally, you know, there is a lot of local influence in the evolution process started.
Right.
In Pakistan, for instance,
mm-hmm.
you see they cook the Punjabi style of
Punjabi style
haris. Okay. Okay. And before partition, it was very popular in Amritsar basically.
Oh, okay.
And now you don't have that food in Amritsar. What you have most of the Delhi or Amritsar or the Punjabi food. Is only you get it either in Karachi or in Lahore, and I have seen it and I have eaten it also.
Okay.
Now you see this, they cook harissa, they call it harissa.
Okay.
And they eat it with bread.
Okay.
So we don't do that. For us, haleem by itself is a whole meal.
Yeah.
And pula aur dali paaye. And you know, when it developed in Hyderabad, you know, it developed in its own way. But the basic ingredient remained the same, wheat and meat. The only thing is that here in India, you know, especially in Deccan, we eat a lot of chilies, little spicy. Now you won't find this in, say, Arab world or in Turkey. Not even, I suppose, in Pakistan.
So what do they substitute the chili with?
Is there, pardon?
Is there anything, do they substitute the chili with something else? Do they use pepper or something else to substitute the flavor?
No,
of the
you
chili?
Know, in Deccan we use, say, for instance, we use black pepper. We use the black
right.
pepper is used throughout the world.
Right.
But here, you know, we use a lot of red pepper. Plus we use green chilies. You know, those things, such things. And then the spices. Now, basic concept of haleem is only meat and wheat.
Right.
Now this chicken haleem, fish haleem, this is all apologies. So they cannot at all become fair. Either it is meat, lamb or beef.
Right, right. And now they have come up with vegetarian haleem.
Now those
and
then
haleem.
They have come up with vegetarian
haleem. Right.
But that nonsense I cannot understand.
Right.
You know, it's something like several fine vegetarian dishes, if you add meat, what happens?
Right.
You lose that.
Right.
Just I give an example, in Hyderabad we cook khatti dal.
Mm-hmm.
suppose you put meat in it, what happens? You see, even vegetarian cooking has got its fineness. It has got wonderful dishes. But it should not be subjected to this kind of. Now you see here, I saw the fish haleem.
Fish haleem.
At one, I saw a board announcing. I saw chicken haleem is of course very, very. But that has more to do with two things. One is the expense.
Okay.
You see, everybody can't afford them. And then, you know, there are certain restrictions on beef.
Right.
They don't want to eat. So, in fact, what beef we get here is all buffalo. And I don't criticize buffalo beef. It's eaten throughout the world.
Right.
It's good. But it should be tender. So now the question of cow beef doesn't arise here. We don't eat.
Right.
I don't think anywhere in Hyderabad that's eaten or cooked.
Mm-hmm.
And haleem, you know, again turning back. You see now what I see in the hotels, I taste it, you see, most of the hotels. So, but I'm sorry, you know, they have lost somewhere on the way, you know, the amount of. The ratio, I think, is they have disturbed.
Yeah.
You know, now you see the haleem, it becomes so thick.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think that is a proper way.
Okay, that's not.
And I don't think it's a proper way. And another thing, they're adding so many spices,
right,
which actually you don't require. Agreed, pure ghee, agreed, cardamoms, shajira, agreed to that. But otherwise, some fellows putting rice, one hotel. When I ate it, you see, I could see the rice in it. So this kind of thing, then there are several others are putting dals.
Right. Also, it's more.
Put chana and tuwar.
Even now, a lot of people use
you see, then this becomes like something like a North Indian khichda or something like, say, the harissa, which I told Punjabis.
Yeah.
It's not our Hyderabad taste. Hyderabad, you know, Hyderabad cooking is very fine in the sense that if you say my haleem, you know, I don't put all those things. I don't even put, say, coriander leaves and mint leaves,
okay,
except as garnish.
Right.
You should understand that whatever goes inside at the time of cooking, it has got its own taste and flavor.
Right.
Now, what is the flavor you require? Ulata namak. So now you see haleem, you know, I don't think ever in the history of Hyderabad,
mm-hmm,
we had so much haleem being cooked.
That is true. Every restaurant, every nook and corner.
Yeah, I don't think this. I've never seen in my life.
Right.
And it seems every year it is growing.
Right.
And I'm glad. Whatever it is, I'm very glad.
Okay.
That people are eating haleem.
Right.
Whatever it might be. And another acceptance.
But does it bother you that, But does it bother you that these people are not following the authentic
way? No, it doesn't bother me at all until people eat it and like it.
Right.
That kind of thing. My recipe up to me.
So this recipe, sir, is it like something that you've incurred from your grandmother or
is the one which I cook, for instance.
Right.
It's very simple.
Okay.
We don't have anything else except wheat and
meat.
Rice. Wheat and meat.
Right.
Nothing else. Okay. I don't use any lentils. I don't use any rice. I don't be using some people put colocasia, arvi.
Yeah.
Now, you see, I don't do all those things. Another thing is that I will not cook haleem without bone.
Okay.
I use meat on bone. Because bone, you know, it imparts a taste, a character.
Right.
That, you see, anybody who eats a boneless meat will not be able to enjoy that. We eat meat always with the bone.
Right.
And we chew the bones also, which are chewable.
Right.
And we enjoy it. So, this is the story. But I'm very glad. The two things, you see, one is the acceptance of, say, non-Muslims. Haleem's acceptance among non-Muslims. I'm very, very glad.
Yes.
I'm very glad because you see, the acceptance of dosas among the Muslims or idli vada sambar. That is, I'm very happy about it.
Right.
This is the food that it should evolve, you know, itself. It should be acceptable to a very large audience.
Right.
So I'm very glad about it. I really, when I asked my this boy, always. What is the percentage of non-Muslims in your restaurant?
Right.
Because I am very, very particular about them. I want them, our culture to be enjoyed by them.
Right.
I want intermingling with them. You see, all those things, you know, food is a medium, you see, which is tremendous, can be used, say, for this purpose.
And do you think this legacy will continue, like, you know, a lot, like you said,
no,
you know,
the as far as the present is concerned,
yeah,
I think it's still evolving itself.
Okay.
Still developing.
So you've never written a, like, if you're against the idea of writing a cookbook or, you know, recording your...
See, I cook for pleasure.
Right.
I get pleasure. This is my hobby.
Right.
You understand? This has never been my commerce. I have cooked at several places throughout the country, outside the country.
Right.
But it has never been commerce. My only intention is that my culture, my Hyderabadi culture, is displayed. People come to know. You know, basically, if you see the food in foreign countries also. Foreign countries also. Mm-hmm. It's Punjabi dominated Indian.
Yeah, yeah. Everybody just thinks butter chicken is the only Indian dish people know about.
It's actually not
Indian.
So, exactly. That's basically Punjabi dominated cooking.
Right.
Tandoori chicken, this,
exactly.
Then naan.
Exactly. True.
But naan, you know, is available in Hyderabad also.
Mm-hmm.
And it's unique. Our Hyderabad naan is not made anywhere in the world. Not even in Pakistan. That's a fact, you see, I have seen there. And my work, whatever I do, is first of all, you know, this is Indian food.
Right.
And Indian food, you know, it has got a lot of ethnicity. From Kerala to Kashmir. From Bengal to Maharashtra.
Right.
And whenever I go, wherever I go, I make it a point that I eat the local ethnic food.
Right.
See, I remember, am I going to Pune? Mm-hmm. I was invited by some very, very good, very close friend of mine, Marathi. I told them very honestly, I want only your local.
Right.
And I had it and I enjoyed it. You see, some things are there which are not acceptable to your palate. Food is personal. But that does not mean that food is bad.
Right.
You don't accept it.
Right.
See, because of certain religious limitations, we don't eat 90% of the French food.
Exactly, because alcohol...
But I have no business to call it, bad.
Right. So what is your favorite cuisine, if you could say so?
And similarly, you know, we don't eat, say, raw fish, what the Japanese do.
Right.
But I have no reason, I have no right to say that they are doing a wrong thing. It is their way of life. If I accept, that's all right. If my palate accepts, I enjoy it. Otherwise, I keep quiet. That is my attitude. But wherever I go, I taste the locals.
Right.
In Kerala, I go usually to my house in the south and I eat. Some of the Kerala food is good.
Right. So what is your favorite cuisine? I mean, definitely Hyderabadi to hoga, but or iske ilawa, what else do you really enjoy to eat, sir?
Middle East food.
Middle East.
Turkish food.
Right.
In fact, I go to Turkey only to eat. Of course, Istanbul is a very beautiful place, there's no doubt about it.
Right.
But the food is magnificent. I go there only for this.
That's amazing.
I make it a point, I go there everywhere. Every time, whenever I get a chance, I go there. And the food, I like it. Sorry, miss, I'm having some food.
No, please, sir. Thank you so much for giving us time. I think I won't disturb you.
I have got a little medical problem. I cannot fast.
Absolutely, sir. I won't disturb you. Thank you so much
right.
for giving us time.
So we are having very good time having Nawab Haleem. We are waiting for that actually. Eppudu vastadani gota kodtane unnaru kotti 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 kodtane unnaru. We are just waiting. So malli next year daaka wait cheyali bhaiya ee Haleem raavadam kosam. But very good that lot of people turned up. We can have very good Haleem actually. Yen 300 km nunchi vachadu
bhaiya. Hi. I came from Palavancha.
Palavancha
Kottagudam. లాస్ట్ ఇయర్ అలీబ్ నవాబ్ అలీబ్ సార్ది మిస్ అయ్యానని అనిపించింది. ఈసారి ఎస్పెషల్లీ రమదాన్ కోసం వెయిట్ చేస్తూ ఇప్పుడు ఐ హ్యావ్ ద ఫార్చ్యూన్ టు కమ్. ఎక్సలెంట్. ఐ వుడ్ లైక్ టు ట్రై అనదర్ డిష్ జాఫ్రాని బిర్యానీ.
జాఫ్రాని
ద సేమ్ థింగ్ ద సేమ్ స్మెల్.
బేసిక్గా ఏంటంటే భయ్య హలీం చాలా చోట్ల మేము చాలా చోట్ల చూసాం. నేను మా కెమెరామెన్ చాలా చోట్ల చూసాం. ఎక్కడ పాలు యాడ్ చేయడం చూడలేదు
ప్రతి దాంట్లో కెమెరామెన్.
సో దిస్ ఈజ్ ఫస్ట్ ప్లేస్ ది యాడ్ మిల్క్. సో మిల్క్ యాడ్ చేయడం ఇదే నేను ఫస్ట్ టైం చూడటం. లైక్ నో ది యాడ్ లాట్ ఆఫ్ మిల్క్ ఇన్ టు ఇట్. ఫ్లేవర్ విల్ బి వెరీ డిఫరెంట్.
ఇట్ ఈస్ క్రేవింగ్ ద స్మెల్ ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ క్రేవింగ్. అండ్ మోర్ ఓవర్ ఐ డి నాట్ టేక్ మై లంచ్ జస్ట్ ఐ హ్యాడ్ మై బ్రేక్ఫాస్ట్ ఫర్ దిస్. నో వన్ బికాస్ ఐ విల్ ట్రై అదర్ డిషెస్ ఆల్సో బికాస్ ఐ హావ్ ఓన్లీ టుడే అండ్ టుమారో.
నేను రాజ్ భయ్య పాండిచేరి నుంచి రాలేదు. పాండి ఫ్లవర్ మన హైదరాబాద్ పెట్టాడు.
హై
లాస్ట్ టైం వెయిట్ రైట్.
యా లాస్ట్ ఇయర్ ఐ కేమ్. ఐఎమ్ స్మెల్లింగ్ ద ఎగ్జాక్ట్ ఫ్లేవర్ ఆఫ్ లాస్ట్ ఇయర్ అండ్ దట్స్ అ కన్సిస్టెన్సీ. ఐ వెయిట్ టు టేస్ట్ ఇట్ ఫర్ దిస్ ఇయర్ బట్ ద ఫ్లేవర్ వాట్ ఐ స్మెల్ లాస్ట్ టైమ్ ఇట్స్ ద సేమ్ ఫ్లేవర్ కమింగ్.
ఇంకోటి ఏంటంటే ఎండలో కలిదిరి పడిపోతే పడిపోయాడు కానీ ఇక్కడికి వచ్చి మళ్ళీ ఇక్కడ కూర్చుని పెట్టిపోయా మనోడు.
ఇట్స్ అ వెరీ హాట్ డే టుడే బికాస్ రవి కాల్ మీ టుడే మార్నింగ్ అండ్ దట్స్ ద రీజన్ ఐఎమ్ హియర్ టుడే. థ్యాంక్ యూ.
హాయ్ ఎవ్రీ వన్, మై నేమ్ ఇస్ అమర్. ఐఎమ్ అ కేరలైట్ హూస్ వర్కింగ్ హియర్ అండ్ అ గుడ్ ఫ్రెండ్ ఆఫ్ మైన్ మిస్టర్ రవితేజ హ్యాస్ ఆబ్వియస్లీ లాస్ట్ టైమ్ వీ హ్యాడ్ అ రియలీ గుడ్ చాట్. నో వీ రియలీ వాక్ త్రూ ద చార్మినార్. Well, I really don't. I'm very much accustomed to walking. Yeah. Exactly. We had the famous ice cream and we ate till the sehri time. And now we are here in the Chichas to taste the Nawabi Haleem. I mean, the recipe is quite secret, just like what you said. That's what I said. It's secret. That's what. Now, I think it's made by a legendary chef. Mehboob Alam Khan, someone like that. Nawab Mehboob Alam Khan. And I'm very happy to hear. I'm waiting till it opens. They said they have been keeping us waiting for quite some time. Almost. Yeah, that's fine. And along with me, I have a good friend of mine, Mr. Shiva.
Actually, ఈ రోజు నాకు ఇంగ్లీష్ క్లాస్ ఉంది కానీ రవితేజన్న చెప్పడం వల్ల ఈ హెల్మెట్ టెస్ట్ చేయడానికి వచ్చాను. అదే భయ్య నువ్వు పోస్ట్ పెడదాం వల్ల.
భయ్య నిజంగా ఇక్కడ రావడానికి మెయిన్ రీజన్ అర్జునే భయ్య. లాస్ట్ ఇయర్ హలీం తిన్నప్పటి నుంచి రవి నవాబ్ హలీం ఎప్పుడు, నవాబ్ సాబ్ హలీం ఎప్పుడు, నవాబ్ సాబ్ హలీం ఎప్పుడు అని చెప్పి బుర్ర తినేశాడు భయ్య. నిజంగా సీరియస్
చెప్పు చెప్పు.
అక్కడ మీరు ఎక్కడ పోయా?
So, bhaiya, basically, this is Haleem we are waiting for from last 1 year for this day, right? As it is, excellent on the bhaiya. And the basic difference between this Haleem and the other Haleems is like a smoothness on today, and then you'll have chunks of meat coming in between so while you're chewing it. It's an amazing feeling to have. Thank you guys. Andaru vachinanduku kottestunnaru bhai janalu black ticket lo kodukunnattu.